Hey guys, in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create an animated picture-in-picture effect. Let's get started. Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're going to look at animating a picture-in-picture effect. And what I've got for you is some footage from Assassin's Creed Rogue with Shay Patrick Cormack about to do a leap of faith. And I've got some stock footage from Storyblocks of a gamer doing his thing. How do we merge the two? Well, let's highlight the B-roll of the gamer and we then want to go in a frame and fit. And from there, if you really just wanted a basic picture-in-picture in the corner, LumaFusion's actually got you covered. If you scroll down here, you'll see you've got top left, top right, left, center, right, and then all the bottom options. So for example, I would prefer to go top right, tap, boom, it's done. What I would do though is I find the gap that they actually create to be a little bit too much. So I would move it in a bit and move it up a bit and just eyeball it. And that's you, pretty much done from there. Now, if that's too much picture in picture, double tap on your video file and just decrease the size. And then just move it in a little bit more and move it up a little bit more. And then just play back again. So that's a basic picture in picture. If we tap on it once more, again, you could just scroll up and then use the positioning option to get you started. What we're gonna do is something a little bit more complicated, easy to do, that gives a much better effect. So to create the animated effect, we're gonna go back into frame and fit. So just double tap on your video clip. And we're first of all gonna go up to cropping. Then you're gonna drop a keyframe at the beginning, then move your timeline along to a second. Now, if you want the process to be slower, obviously increase the duration between the start and the end of the effect, but I'm going to go for a second. And then from there, I'm going to bring my left side in around about 20. I'll just tap that down to 20 and then do the same with the right. Get it as close as possible. 2020, and that gives you a rough sort of square. It's not quite square, but it's square enough. We're then going to come back to our size and position. Now let's first of all test out the cropping coming in and that being animated. That looks good. And then you want to repeat the procedure with the size and position. Again, go to the beginning of the timeline, drop a keyframe in the corner, move along, and then from there you can make your adjustments. So the first thing to do is shrink down your picture in picture to the size you want it to be. Probably going to go for 30, and then all I'm going to do is just click and drag it with my Apple Pencil up to the corner and just gonna position it to position X 80, say minus 66, just eyeballing it. And that's you, you're pretty much done. So we go back to the beginning, come out to full screen. You can see there's the effect. Let's play it through. It's as simple as that. Now just to kind of give a little bit of extra pizzazz, you can add a little flash transition at the beginning, and I've kept that to just 20 frames, and then at the end, or when you want the picture in picture to disappear, then go down to slide, and counterintuitively, if you've never watched any of my video tutorials before, when you're using slide on the beginning and the end of a single clip, you have to do the opposite. So I want this picture in picture to go up the way. Now the automatic choice for that would be slide up, but what you're actually going to use is slide down, because it's doing the opposite. And you'll see by doing slide down it goes up, and again I'm doing that over 20 frames. So let's just zoom out a little bit. I'll double tap on the screen and then we play it through. And there you go, there's your animated picture-in-picture effect. This is obviously can be used for gaming. It can be used if you, like me, do video tutorials. Just finish it off, zoom, and it disappears. It can be used for video tutorials, gaming, or any kind of thing whereby you need to have two pieces of video footage running at the same time. And there we go. So if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If I have your intro subscription, then subscribe. And don't forget to check the little bell so that you're notified the next time I put out a video tutorial. And I will catch you on the next one. Bye.